National tournament just really shows the consistency with those guys able to execute every day. But, you know, you turn the page today, and this is totally a different team.
So now the home opener today as Vanderbilt takes the field. We'll see that young man make his first start, Jack Leiter. Kind of what Kumar Rocker was last year as a freshman. Jack Leiter, sort of the same thing. Of course, good family bloodlines as far as pitching goes, and we'll see what the freshman from Summit, New Jersey has in store. D1 Baseball says he's the number two impact freshman in the SEC. Picked in the 20th round by the Yankees last year, but chose to come play for Vanderbilt. Gatorade Player of the Year in the state of New Jersey. And Coach Tim Corbin says his maturity is noticeable, really competes in everything he does, and a low-maintenance player. So looking forward to seeing Jack Leiter make his first appearance and first start for this Vanderbilt team. Lineup for South Alabama. It's a good team, as we mentioned. They won 2 out of 3 against Campbell over the weekend. Ethan Wilson, a home run and 5 RBIs, the Sunbelt Preseason Player of the Year. Michael Sandel, 3 for 11. 4-game hitting streak going back to last season coming in. Stokes, Montiel, and Wilson at the top. Delatorre, Sandel, and Lewis in the middle. Daly, Davis, Lewis, the bottom three for Coach Mark Calvi in year number 9. Well, we talked about it being a rebuilt team for Vanderbilt. Rebuilt lineup, rebuilt defensive alignment as well. Davis, Kolak, and Thomas in the outfield. Austin Martin, preseason All-American at third. Young, Ray, and Jones around the infield. And the very talented Rodriguez behind the plate. CJ had an outstanding opening weekend with Leiter on the mound. And Tim Corbin once again in the Vanderbilt dugout. Year 18 as Vanderbilt coach, 23rd season overall. 741 wins as coach of the Commodores and enters his 23rd season with 846 wins. Those milestone wins come a little faster when you win 59, don't they?
Very true. Very true. Tim Corbin inducted in the ABCA National Coaches Hall of Fame earlier this year. Deserving honor there.
He said after that opening weekend in Arizona, Vanderbilt won on Saturday against UConn, but lost a couple heartbreakers on Friday and on Sunday. Had leads going into the ninth, couldn't hang on. Says they got a lot to do. Long way to go, a lot of holes to correct. See how this team gets rolling here as we move through this 2020 season. New year, a new decade as Leiter delivers the first pitch strike to Hunter Stokes.
I think what you saw last year from this Commodore team is the consistency throughout the midweeks is really what propelled them to that offseason, in large part due to Mason Hickman giving Commodore some really good starts in that midweek, so trying to see if Leiter can do something similar here.
Stokes already with some heroics on his resume for 2020, a ninth inning home run in their opener for a win, and a good start for Leiter with a strikeout to start the day.
3 pitches, 3 strikes, 3 swings. Just a fastball up in the zone. Leiter gonna come at you with a good fastball, low 90s, but also has a plus changeup, plus breaking pitch. We'll see a couple of those as the game goes on, but really using that fastball early on.
The experienced Santi Montiel steps in for USA. Over the weekend, 2 for 3, a 2-run scored and 2 RBIs in the second game of that series. Inside, a ball on a strike. Weather has not been all that hot today. We've had not really downpours, but just light rain throughout the day. It's about as good right now as it's been throughout the afternoon here, and we'll see how that goes as well as we get through the evening. Breaking pitch. Ball and 2 strikes.
Yeah, it wouldn't be Nashville weather in February if it wasn't on the cusp of, you know, 50s and 40s and a little sprinkle. Another slider there from Leiter.
Misses away, 2 balls and 2 strikes. Struck out Stokes. 3 pitches to start things, 2 and 2. On the outside corner with a fastball for strike 3. Good location.
Yeah, Leiter was able to set up that outside fastball with the previous slider on the outside. Got the pitcher, the hitter to extend that zone. Able to dot it right on the outside corner. Good stick there by Rodriguez. Again, we were talking about the rain and you know, watching. You might not be able to really tell a difference, but the turf is completely new. They had that done in the fall. It redid the whole drainage system. So not going to see much of the pooling of the water that you saw last year.
Tim Corbin said it's a little more crown to allow for some more drainage. This guy has been awesome. Ethan Wilson, home run and tied a career high with five RBIs in the second game over the weekend. Part of the Golden Spikes watch list and the preseason player of the year in the Sun Belt. He was co-freshman of the year, is named by Collegiate Baseball nationally last year, and also the Sun Belt player of the year in 2019. It's 17 home runs to break the South Alabama freshman record and among the conference leaders in several different categories. Ball and a strike. Foul tip, 1-2.
Yeah, and these South Alabama hitters are definitely getting their hacks in. They're not taking many pitches. I think you'll see a lot of that. These hitters coming in to Vanderbilt. Vanderbilt wins the national championship. They're coming in and saying, hey, we don't care. We're going to put the ball in play and try and get some early.
Leiter strikes out the side. How's that for a start? Two swinging, one looking. It gets Stokes, Montiel, and Wilson. Commodores lead things off with Austin Martin in just a moment. We check in with a new member on our crew this year. We're thrilled to have her, Kayla Anderson, down in the third base dugout.
Hey, you guys, thanks so much. Well, Tim Corbin praised last year's leadership group, led by five seniors, but this dugout looks a lot different this year. Only two seniors returning, one of those second baseman, Harrison Ray. Now, he was one of the first to step up after this weekend's play, saying, quote, hey, you guys, we got a lot of seeing ourselves. When it comes down to ourselves, we just need to be better. That's a true leader right there. As for Ty Duvall, we have not seen him in action yet. He's been dealing with an illness, but I will say this. He elected to come back this year after being drafted by the Oakland A's. Both of these guys will be a crucial part of this year's team and guiding these young guys in the right direction. Guys, we'll send it back to you.
All right, thanks a lot, Kayla. And yeah, they will be very important, Andrew, as you try to find new leaders for this Vanderbilt squad. Well, there is Matt Boswell getting the start of the mound for South Alabama. He's a junior right-hander. Scoreless ninth for the save back over the weekend in the second game of their series out of Destin, Florida. Brother and cousin also played college ball, and he'll face the Vanderbilt lineup today, which will include Harrison Ray. We'll show you in just a moment. Matt Boswell on the mound for the Jaguars of South Alabama. Vanderbilt lineup with Austin Martin at the top, the preseason All-American. 2-for-10 in that series out in Arizona, the three games anyway. Cooper Davis, C.J. Rodriguez went 6-for-12 with three RBIs, a freshman catcher. We'll see who's in the DH role. Isaiah Thomas, Spencer Jones, Harrison Ray. Kayla was talking about Tate Colwick and Carter Young, the bottom of the order for Coach Tim Corbin. South Alabama team defensively had a good opening weekend. Only two errors in the three games. Wilson, Sandel, and Lewis in the outfield. Stokes, Montiel, Daly, and De La Torre around the infield with Lewis, the catcher, and Boswell on the mound. Mark Calvi is the head coach for South Alabama. Saying he was happy with two out of three and clinching the series against Campbell over the weekend, talking about it's tough to sweep a doubleheader, but told her, guys, not going to Vanderbilt just to be spectators. Going to go up here and play and try to win. Great opportunity to play a good team on the road. So he expects his guys to show up. It's a business trip. Two games today and then tomorrow. First two home games for Vanderbilt. Start of an 11-game homestand.
Yeah, I think you saw a similar mindset from some of those teams out in Arizona. When you're ranked in the top one or two standings at the beginning of the year, you just got a giant target on your back. And Tim Corbin actually talked about that before the season. As you win the national championship, and then all the coaches decide, hey, well, let's just give them that number one spot so that everyone hates them. And you got to get that target on your back, and you're going to get everyone's best. And I think you saw that out in Arizona. I mean, none of those teams quit. The Michigan game, the Cal Poly game.
Yeah, we saw a ninth inning home run in that Michigan game, and Matthew Schmidt went yard in the ninth. Vanderbilt had a chance to win, came back against Cal Poly, and ended up coming up short. Austin Martin He came very close to hitting 400 last season. He was just amazing throughout the year. Junior utility man has shown he can play a little bit of everywhere, whether it's infield or outfield, but steady presence at third base.
Now, some people thought that with Ethan Paul leaving shortstop, they might move Martin over to shortstop, but Tim Corbin keeping him there at third base. Regardless of wherever he plays in the field, he's a force to be reckoned with once he gets on base and also at the plate.
Outside, a ball and a strike. He went 2-for-3 at the walk and 3 runs scored against Cal Poly on Sunday. Junior from Jacksonville, preseason All-American, first team All-American, All-SEC, All-Defensive Team a season ago. Pulls this one foul.
Another guy on the Golden Spikes watch list.
Mm-hmm. Tim Corbin says he's competitive as any guy we've had at Vanderbilt. And really proud of his growth away from the field. Said he leads in his own way. We were talking about new leaders. And Harrison Ray and Ty Duvall certainly the ones. And Austin Martin right there as well. 1-2 pitch. Evens the count. The first batter of the day for Vanderbilt. Martin Davis and Rodriguez to start the game.
It was a lineup that has a lot of young guys that haven't had too much experience. To be able to put a guy like Martin at the top, really kind of spark that offense, is so nice to have him come back for next year.
Count runs full. Get Martin on base. He is an immediate threat to get into scoring position. Opening inning. So Jack Leiter sit him down in order on strikeouts. Payoff pitch coming up to Martin. Just outside third, and he'll do it again. And did not miss by much, being extra bases. Another 3-2 pitch coming up from Boswell to Martin. Pop foul. Will drift outside first. Some hearty fans out here, as we always do.
Mm-hmm.
We'll be evaluating the effort of those trying to catch foul balls throughout the season.
A pretty good showing from South Alabama.
Mm-hmm. Payoff pitch number 3 to Martin. Over to short. Montiel with a chance. Guns it across, but De La Torre can't hang on. And Martin reaches to start the first for Vanderbilt.
And Martin is definitely going to put the ball in play. Doesn't strike out a lot. Montiel has to hurry up a little bit. Some, probably some moisture on the ball as well. But De La Torre not able to come up with the pick. I actually think Martin thought he was out. Didn't realize that De La Torre wasn't able to hang on to that.
They originally said a base hit. Now they'll scored an error on Montiel, which is kind of a tough error because that throw was online. Get a true hop off the turf. Martin is the first base runner for either team, and Cooper Davis steps in. Davis drags it down the first base side. Not in time. Daly didn't get over to cover the bag quickly enough. Vanderbilt has first and second with nobody out.
And that's about as good as a drag bunt as you can get from Davis. He's watch all three guys converge. Second baseman Daly lagging a little bit to get the first base. Trying to catch the ball and tag that baseman with his left foot at the same time when Davis is coming down the line. Really good bunt.
Well, this guy's had a terrific start to his Vanderbilt career. 6-for-12 on opening weekend. C.J. Rodriguez, a freshman catcher. 4 hits against UConn with 3 RBIs. team high 8 total bases. First and second. First inning jam for Matt Boswell. Go back to Austin Martin on that play at first base. The throw bounced and he was headed back to the dugout. Hey, wait a minute.
I think Coach David Macias at first base said, hey, he dropped it.
I'll go back to the dugout just yet. He's standing in second. Boswell working out of the stretch. Almost looks like he's had a little difficulty getting together with his catcher. One ball count to Rodriguez. Runners take their leads. And gets away from Powers behind the plate. Vanderbilt has two in scoring position. Scored about a pass ball on Powers.
Yeah, I thought initially that might have been a cross-up, but I think the ball just got away from him. Right off the inside lip of Powers' glove. A good spot for Rodriguez here.
We're going to see Ty Duvall bat. He will be the designated hitter. Foul at the plate, 2-1. Opening inning, Vanderbilt with a threat, trying to get on the board first. Two-one pitch, Scott out towards center. Sandel comes in a few steps. We'll see if they send Martin from third, they will. Nope, it's gonna put on the brakes. Took a few steps and stopped, and probably a good decision.
Mm-hmm. I thought that was a little bit further out in right center. Had an opportunity, but.
So here is Ty Duvall. Officially a pinch hitter as Mason Hickman was listed as the DH. Senior from Lebanon, Ohio. Really good behind the plate and really good at the plate. Vanderbilt went 22-1 in the 23 starts he made at catcher last season. Had 16 RBIs in his last 16 games and hits in 15 of his last 20. Runners at second and third, and now with one out.
Duvall battled a little bit of injury in the fall, didn't get too many reps. Has been sick recently, so coming off a little bit of sickness. That's why Rodriguez has gotten a lot of the reps. Probably helped out Rodriguez in the fall just to get a little bit more reps with some of those pitchers, but Duvall being a senior, very important to this lineup.
Foul the breaking pitch out of play, 1-1. Austin Martin reached on an error by the shortstop. Cooper Davis dragged bunt for a hit. Moved up on a pass ball and stand at second and third. This is outside, 2-1. Duvall ahead in the count. Boswell trying to get a big second out. Lined up the middle. Will get down for a hit. And we'll bring in the first two runs of the day. Martin followed by Davis. It's 2-0 Vanderbilt and two RBIs for Duvall.
Did a solid piece of hitting there by Duvall. The fastball in the outside corner sits back on it. A heck of a base running job by Davis. The throw comes into Daly. And he has to hesitate because he doesn't realize that Davis is going to be all the way around from second base to score.
Isaiah Thomas bats, one out and two in. Duvall at first. Hit through the hole on the right side. They had Daly playing up the middle. That's a base hit. We'll see Duvall put on the brakes at second, and Thomas again gets Vanderbilt two base runners with only one out.
Yeah, two good at bats back to back. That's a slider on the outside corner. Thomas just shoots it the other way. I think we saw a lot of this last year. Just put good at bats together, really manufacture a lot of runs. Obviously, they had a lot of the guys that could drive it out of the park, but I feel like a lot of those games that, you know, put up a crooked number, it was just one good at bat after another.
That's the way big innings go a lot of times. It's not necessarily home runs. It's just to keep it moving. Extra base hit brings in a couple, and then you kind of keep runners on base throughout the inning.
I think with losing a lot of those guys that did have the big home run numbers, I mean, the Commodores led the league in 100 home runs last year, so tough to replace that.
It just seems like a crazy number.
They're going to have to manufacture runs in a different way. And they've done that before. I mean, I think back to even that World Series team in 2014, yeah, they had a couple of guys that put up some good numbers, but majority of the guys just had some good averages, and they're able to bunt and get guys over and get guys in. You mix that with a good pitching staff, and you're on your way to the playoffs.
There's a strike to make it 2-1, 2-1 to Spencer Jones. I always thought it was interesting that 2014 season, they did not have a home run the entire postseason until the final game. That was the one that made the difference. Jones bats two for his first nine with four runs scored.
If you're looking for guys that can potentially get some power, Spencer Jones is that guy. Take a look at the last pitch. A little bit outside. Jones puts really good contact on the ball. I'm just watching him a little bit in the fall and some of the inner squads. He's a big kid, so once he continues to make good contact.
Good contact there, but might be a double play. 1-6, safe at first. Couldn't turn it quickly enough. Duvall ends up at third. Thomas is out at second. Two gone.
Pretty good snag there by Boswell. Didn't try and do too much. Just gets the lead runner. That's really all you have to do. With the moisture on the ground and with this turf, a lot of the rain kind of sits on top of the turf. It doesn't soak in, so sometimes you grab the ball and it's just soaking wet. So taking care of the baseball and not trying to do too much, just trying to get one out at a time, it's very important as a defense.
Yeah, definitely want to make sure you get something right there. And that can often be a tough throw for a pitcher to make that solid delivery to second. Pop up on the first pitch by Harrison Ray. We'll get South Alabama out of the inning with really a minimum of damage as Ray pops out to second. Two runs, three hits, no errors. The big hit by that man, Ty Duvall, brought in two. Commodores an early lead over South Alabama. There you go. Opening day at Hawkins Field. A couple of those pennants up here. Autographed Vandy Boys calendar. The new national championship trophy isn't very far away, too. If you kind of pan over there to the right, they got both of them, 2014 and 2019. Right down on the concourse, Vanderbilt 2-0 over South Alabama. We start inning number two. Commodores with a two-run single by Ty Duvall to bring in a pair of runs. Hard to get off to a better start than Jack Leiter did. He struck out the side in the first inning. Now we'll pitch to the middle of the batting order for South Alabama, including Caleb Della Torre. A tough go of it on opening weekend, 1-for-12. Didn't have an RBI. They have some preseason all-conference selections in the Sun Belt. He is one of them. All 56 games as a junior last year, he hit .301. 15 doubles, couple triples, six home runs, 37 RBIs, and scored 40. It's even better than that in Sun Belt play. Leiter, a big breaking pitch. Two balls and a strike.
Delatorre, one of the older players on the South Alabama team. Only have three freshmen on the entire team, so a very experienced squad. Guys have had a lot of at-bats.
Fastball away, 3-1. Saw Leiter really get ahead of the hitters in that opening inning.
Mm-hmm. Rain is starting to come down a little bit, so maybe a little bit of moisture on the ball.
Inside corner with a fastball. Run the count full.
We've seen over the years some of the guys that really come after the hitters and they work fast. Sometimes they can work themselves into a little bit of a hole, but Leiter came back 3-2.
Sky toward left. Davis, a couple steps in front of the track, makes a catch. First ball put in play by South Alabama. Flyout by Delatorre. Michael Sandel, he's the center fielder. Hits in all three games to start things off. They hit a run on RBI, a couple stolen bases in the third game of their series with Campbell over the weekend. Uses the breaking pitch to start off the at-bat. Back to it, 0-2.
Yeah, Leiter's not messing around. You mentioned Tim Corbin said Leiter's a pretty quiet kid, but just goes in, gets his work done, not looking to goof around. Good spot.
Boy, Sandel chases away. Three pitches, three strikes, two gone.
Comes with a fastball, then a slider, then an extended slider outside the zone. That was really tough to lay off of as a right-handed hitter.
Well, two gone for Reed Powers, junior catcher. Out of play on the first pitch. Game two of that series over the weekend, a career high three hits. Home run, a couple RBIs. Dialing it up there, no balls and two strikes.
They're just sitting right there at about 92.
Trying to sit him down in order for the second straight inning. Couldn't hit the outside edge there. Ball and two strikes.
And not a bad spot. A little bit outside the zone. Trying to get him to extend. Mm-hmm. Might see another one of those, or might see another of those sliders on the outside corner. I think he was trying to. Wasn't able to get on top of it.
Leiter's worked very quickly. A little walk here and throw a 2-2 to Powers. He can reach Dakota Daly, will bat. Raining about as hard as it has since the game started. Keep the bat dry and the baseball. There you go. Another 2-2. End of the inning as Powers is called out on strikes. A fly out and two more Ks for Jack Leiter. It's like he's made a whole bunch more college starts than just start number one. Vanderbilt leading 2-0 and an inning and a half done in Nashville. Well, back at Hawkins Field, Vanderbilt leading 2-0 over South Alabama. Well, they raise those flags when somebody from Vanderbilt makes the big leagues, and that's for Mike Yastrzemski. Really good for the San Francisco Giants. It was pretty cool when he played at Fenway Park and his mm-hmm. grandfather was there and that whole scene, and that was really neat, and he really played well in that series.
Really, really cool. For him to get that chance and not only at Fenway, but just get the chance to play in the bigs. And the numbers that he put up, especially the power numbers, and they weren't wall scrapers. I mean, right. He was hitting some big, big home runs. And that is a kid who has just worked his tail off. I'm very happy for Yaz.
One of 15 former Vanderbilt players in the majors last year, led the nation. Ted Kolwick, the Vandy center fielder, starts off the second. Saw this guy in some limited action last year. Played four games at second base. Good game against Tennessee Tech back last April. Out of Arlington High School in Memphis. Guy Tim Corbin says is a positive force every time he shows up at the field. Good summer and showed improvement over the fall in the starting lineup here. 8-9-1 coming up for Vandy. Kolwick, Young, and Martin. Two balls and a strike from Matt Boswell. Bounce back to the mound. Boswell, good start to the second as he gets the out of Kolwick. Thought he did some good damage control last inning. He gave up a couple runs in the single by Duvall, but then was able to get out of another situation with two base runners.
Yeah, I think Boswell's done a good job of trying to extend the zone a little bit outside. He hasn't really come in on anybody. He's not going to blow anybody away with this fastball, but really settled in after those two runs. Trying to get some of those guys to get overextended and a little bit too aggressive. You see a lot of those balls off the end of the bat. Kind of weak ground balls up the middle.
Carter Young, the freshman shortstop. A couple hits, a run, an RBI against UConn in the win on Saturday. Behind here, 0-2. First team All-State and 2A Player of the Year out in Washington. The Gatorade Player of the Year back in 2018. Under Armour All-American, won a couple state championships. Boswell trying to get the first two out in the Vanderbilt second. Good. Does so as he strikes out Young. Two gone and back to the top for Austin Martin.
What a solid pitch and change up on the outside corner. Just goes off the plate, Young. A little bit out in front. That's what I was saying. He just tries to extend a little bit offside. Mm-hmm. The batter is into the bat. Boswell starting to settle in here.
It's like you see more guys throw that pitch these days, don't mm-hmm. you? That's a really good out pitch. Martin, first pitch, sends it to center. Sandel settles in for the out. And a good second turned in by Matt Boswell. Three up, three down for the Commodores. 2-0 advantage for Vandy. Bottom of the order coming up against Jack Leiter. Just one. Vanderbilt freshman Jack Leiter has been outstanding so far, has retired all six hitters he has faced, including five strikeouts. Andrew, working fast, power stuff looks really good.
Yeah, really just getting ahead of the hitters with the fastball. And if it's been working for him, he hadn't really deviated much from that. And his out pitch has been that slider on the outside corner, especially to the right-handers. I hadn't seen the changeup too much. I think we'll see a little bit more of that with the left-handed batters, but really good stuff from the freshman so far.
Senior second baseman Dakota Daly will lead things off for South Alabama, followed by Alden Davis and Carter Quinn. Inning number three. One ball and one strike. Daly went 2-for-8 with three runs scored in an RBI in their series against Campbell. We play in the rain. weather was about as good at first pitch as it's been all afternoon. The game has picked up as we move through these first couple innings. Three balls and a strike.
Not a bad spot, maybe a little up. Good frame job by Rodriguez.
Fly ball out of play. We'll make it 3-2. Only the second batter, memory serves. He's gone three balls against so far.
Leiter has been so aggressive against these hitters and gotten a good rhythm. If you're South Alabama, just try and get somebody on base, get him in the stretch, mix up his rhythm a little bit.
Payoff to the leadoff man, Daly. Strike three on the corner. He's been able to hit that spot and get the strikeouts.
That might have been a little bit generous, but Leiter had been attacking that outside part of the zone. Another good frame job by Rodriguez, the catcher.
Scott Klein rings him up. Now it's Alden Davis. He's in the DH spot. That's a really good JUCO player in the state of Mississippi at a Pascagoula High School. Six strikeouts already for Leiter. His first career start. Davis says his favorite movie is The Waterboy. Playing the H2O here. This is bounced right side and foul, 2-2.
I feel like that movie is a little old for him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's been a minute. What, maybe 20 years or so?
Yeah. It was like my era.
Swing and a miss. Leiter, you can do it. Mowing him down.
Came out of his shoes. And take a look at the sequence here from Leiter. Comes inside with the fastball. Gets a little bit up and away, some moisture. Low in the dirt with the slider. Spots up with the fastball, then comes right back inside. So working in and out. Still relying on that fastball. Good command.
Carter Quinn is the right fielder. Leiter tries to make it through the batting order first time without allowing a base runner. One ball and one strike. Quinn made his South Alabama debut in a pinch hitter role in game three of their series over the weekend. Fouled away. Leiter ahead of the hitters. He has been throughout this first trip through the batting order. Strike three on the breaking pitch. Another three strikeout inning for Leiter. Only one ball put in play through the first three. Going to the hook. 8 Ks for Leiter. 2-0 Vandy. Well, a two-run single by Ty Duvall and some outstanding pitching by the freshman Jack Leiter. Been the story for Vanderbilt so far, leading South Alabama 2-0 as we get set for the bottom of the third. Playing in the rain. Rain of no consequence. Hardcore Vanderbilt fans out here checking out opening day. It's supposed to be nicer tomorrow. A little cooler. Kevin Ingram, Andrew Harris, Kayla Anderson, our whole crew. We should be a little nicer to the new people who bring in Kayla and it pours down rain the whole first game.
It's not like she gets to sit in the dugout. I mean, you got to sit near the TV booth.
Stand out there.
Just wear it.
Wear it, exactly. Doug Stanton is cozy down in the control room. Cooper Davis drag bunt for a single and came around to score on the single by Duvall back in the first. Guy who supposedly does a good Tim Corbin impersonation, which I am very interested to hear.
Yeah, we talked about Tim Corbin at the beginning of the season. Said apparently Cooper Davis does a really good impression of me, but he'll never do it in front of me.
Yeah.
And he said, I'm thinking it's really good because all the guys always try and get him to do it.
Foul back and ball and two strikes. Matt Boswell after a tough first inning got him out in order in the second. I can appreciate that because, you know, people put the pressure on you to do impersonations and it gets a little more difficult. When there are no expectations, it's not nearly as hard. Bounces that one up there to make it 2-2. We'll see Davis, Rodriguez, and Duvall for Vanderbilt in inning three. Cooper just seems like one of those fun guys to have. Every team has him that keeps everybody loose. Had a good opening weekend. And hits this one back up the middle for a leadoff single in the third.
That's what Davis brings to the table. The guy who's going to put the ball in play, has good wheels. It's not a bad spot on the outside corner. Davis just goes right back up the middle. You think about it, if Austin Martin doesn't get on, Cooper Davis has a very good chance of getting on as well. So he allowed him to have, you know, Martin and Davis at the top of the order. It allows you to jumpstart your offense and get guys on base who know how to run the bases.
It's almost like you have two leadoff men there at the top because we saw Davis in that role some last year. C.J. Rodriguez, a flyout, 0 for 1. We have a second flyout. This one popped toward short right. It is Quinn, one gone. So Boswell gets Rodriguez on one pitch, and now the guy who has had the big hit of this game so far, and that's Ty Duvall. Lined a single to center that brought in two with one out in the first.
You see the rain coming down a little bit harder. The wind has actually shifted too. It was blowing straight out to right center. Now it looks like it's blowing in from left center. Ball's probably staying in the park here.
Davis had a short lead but takes off and has the stolen base. Ball got loose, but Montiel backing up on the play. Davis in scoring position.
Davis got a really good jump. And it's our first look at a slide on the wet field. Looks like it's a little bit more true.
That ball got him in the helmet, didn't it?
Yeah, I think it did. Maybe in the bill.
I was with you, though. I was thinking Cooper need to go ahead and slide.
Yeah.
Getting up out in left field. Well, Boswell gets an awkward swing out of Duvall. Ball and a strike.
Yeah, they didn't make too many changes to the field. I mean, the coloring is pretty similar. I will say the turf might be a little bit of a lighter brown color.
Mm-hmm.
The cutouts, I think, are a little bit more angular. But all in all, pretty similar.
Boswell gets the breaking pitch over. 1-2 to Duvall. There it is. Looks great. This artificial surface has really saved a lot of games over the last few years that they had the old field and now the new one. 1-2, hit hard to right, but not really going anywhere. Quinn has his second put out of the inning, and Davis stays put at second. And when they tore out the old turf, they completely redid the drainage system. There was like a big moat dug out in right field. It was wild to see how they installed all that with the rock and everything that goes underneath.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely saves a bunch of games. I will say, I am mad that, I mean, none of these kids ever get to know what a tarp pole is like. They don't know what it's like to be called in the middle of the night to come pull the tarp because there's a pop-up storm.
maybe on a holiday. Line out to center. Off the bat of Isaiah Thomas, Matt Boswell settled in nicely. Base hit, one left for Vanderbilt. 2-0 Commodores after three. Two nothing Vanderbilt. South Alabama will set up the top of the order against Jack Leiter, who has sat down all nine he has faced so far. And eight of the nine have been strikeouts. The only ball put in play was by Caleb Della Torre, a fly out to left leading off the second. Stokes, Montiel, and Wilson, top three in the Jags batting order. Austin Martin checks the defensive alignment. Plays in a little in front of the bag, off the third baseline. Leiter, for the most part, has gotten ahead of the hitters. He's mixed up the pitches. Good fastball. We've seen, Andrew, a slider and a curve that he got for that last strikeout of Carter Quinn.
Yeah, we've seen the slider used. He's trying to extend the zone, especially to those right-handers. They're more of an over-the-top, a little bit softer breaking pitch. But if you can manipulate the ball like that, just increase your repertoire.
Less than perfect conditions.
Let's have a good look at that curveball. Mm-hmm.
One ball, two strikes.
You'll see where this thing starts and where it ends, right at the top of the zone, right at the bottom.
Right on the inner edge. Stokes out on strike, swinging for the second time. Santi Montiel will check in. He was called out on strikes in the first. We check in again with Kayla Anderson in the third base dugout.
Hey, guys. Well, here's the thing. Jack Leiter, he is something special. If you go back in his family lineage, it's baseball that runs through his blood. His father, of course, Al, was a major league pitcher for about 19 seasons, and then you go down the line, his uncle Mark was in the majors for 11 years, and then even Mark Jr., his cousin, was a major league pitcher for 2 years. The funny thing is Jack is a right-handed pitcher, so are his uncle and his cousin, but his father, Al, was actually a lefty, you guys, so I don't know where Al didn't get the memo there.
Yeah, Kayla, I was thinking, you know, when they started talking about Jack Leiter is going to come here to play, it's like, oh, he's got to be a left-hander,
right?
Doesn't he? And
yeah.
That is good stuff with the family lineage there. All making it to the big leagues. A second ball of the day put in play by Montiel, and it's a bounce out to second as Ray throws him out for out number two.
You think about the... just throwing in the backyard with your dad, the amount of, you know, knowledge that he has, and being able to say, hey, you know, when you're up against these right-handed hitters, something that I used to do that was helpful. I'm used to be able to have that is so invaluable.
Al Leiter was an excellent big league pitcher for a long time. Breaking pitch for a strike to Ethan Wilson. Preseason player of the year in the Sun Belt. He was a strikeout victim in the first. And bats with two gone in the fourth. Mentioned he was among the conference leaders in several categories in the Sun Belt last year. One pitch. Gets the backstop, 345 average, had 16 doubles, 17 home runs, 51 RBIs, 151 total bases, 59 runs, 686 slugging percentage, and a 453 on-base percentage. Probably take a couple more years of that.
What's he talking about?
Two balls and a strike. He's trying to give South Alabama his first base runner of the day against Leiter. 3-1.
I think we mentioned earlier, Wilson also, in addition to Martin, on the Golden Spikes list. You don't really usually see the amount of players on that list in a midweek game between these two.
Hackett on 3-1, count runs full. Nine strikeouts for Leiter, ready to go to work against Wilson. Try to wrap up the fourth. The payoff. Just missed inside, and the first base runner is a sophomore left fielder, and that'll bring up Della Torre with two out and one on.
Not a bad spot. A little bit inside. I think it got away from him a little bit. But a first base runner for South Alabama. Get Leiter out of that windup, get him out of his rhythm. Try and get him in the stretch. See if they can work with it.
The stretch for the first time today. Rodriguez, a good job to keep in front of him. Keep the runner at first.
See the breaking pitch out of the stretch.
But it hit the chest protector and Wilson stays put. Short lead at first, runner going. We'll have to come back, one and one.
South Alabama putting the gas pedal on. Got two outs, trying to send the runner, trying to make something happen.
They were successful in steal attempts in their opening series. The lineup in play today, combined 5 for 5. Strike on the inside corner, 1-2.
A little knee buckling there from Della Torre. A 1-2 count. Might come back to it. Might try and come inside with something fast.
First time through the batting order, only one to put it in play, a fly out to left. Runner Wilson will get on down to second. Count goes to 2-2.
Yeah, that was a good dirt ball read there from Wilson. As soon as he saw that ball in the dirt in front of Rodriguez, he able to get that good secondary take off. It's a huge bag.
Sure is.
Get that runner in scoring position.
Two out hit cuts the lead in half for Vanderbilt. Up 2-0 here in the fourth with two gone. Leiter goes back to the breaking pitch and runs the count full. Glance into the dugout. See what Scott Brown has in mind for Jack Leiter. First real trouble of the day. Two out base runner in scoring position. Another payoff pitch. Our first foul ball into Vanderbilt Stadium of the season. Della Torre can reach. Michael Sando will bat. Payoff number two. Pop up left side. Davis. Right on the line. Got it to end the inning. Circle to make the play. No hits, one left. Vanderbilt 2, South Alabama nothing. Middle of the fourth in the Music City. A rainy late afternoon, early evening at Hawkins Field. There we are. Kevin Ingram, Andrew Harris, Kayla Anderson.
If you can see us through the rain.
Uh-huh. Vanderbilt in front by 2 runs against South Alabama. Jack Leiter has faced only 13 hitters through the first 4 innings. And really, Matt Boswell's done a good job settling in after Vanderbilt scored 2 runs in the first on a single by Ty Duvall. Only allowed 1 hit since then. That was a third inning single by Cooper Davis. Spencer Jones, Harrison Ray, take Colwick coming up for Vandy. Inning four, the home opener. First time the Commodores have played in this park since defeating Duke to advance to Omaha back last spring. Spencer Jones reached on a fielder's choice back in the first, was stranded there. It's a breaking pitch, ball and a strike. Some fun times last year. Vanderbilt restocking a bit here in 2020 after the national championship season. Good pitch in the outer half, 1-2.
And definitely restocking with the top-ranked recruiting class. This is one of those guys, one of the top left-handed pitchers and recruits in the country.
Pulled that one down to first. Big hop for De La Torre. Gets the bag, one out.
Some other miss hits. Boswell just staying down in the zone, staying away from a lot of those hitters, making them get themselves out. As a hitter, sometimes if a guy's not really going to blow anything by you, you might even get up on the plate a little bit to just give yourself a little bit more room. Because if he throws it inside, you can turn on it. But that's exactly what he wants you to do, is you kind of reach out there and try and get it, and reach it off the end of your bat. If you can give a couple more inches, at least you get a little bit more of a barrel on it.
Harrison Ray popped out to second in his first at bat, ball and no strikes. 1-1. Guy Tim Corbin calls the consummate team guy, versatile, adaptable, and tough. It's really been interesting to watch how he's progressed over the course of his career, now becoming really the veteran presence on this team.
I think he's always done a really good job offensively, but defensively, I mean, his game has really improved from when he was a freshman. Take a look at the slider inside. But Ray is a freshman, played a couple different positions in his sophomore year, kind of bounced around. He played a little bit of third base when Martin was injured, but moved over to second base last year and had a really good year there.
Did he hold up? He did. It's 2-2. He became just a very solid second baseman. How many plays did we see him make where he ranged out in a short right and get to a ball? He was sure good in the College World Series, an 11-game on-base streak to end the season. Three hits, two runs, couple RBIs in the finals.
Nice little at bat here from Ray. Holds up on a tough slider on the outside corner, fouls off another one down in the zone.
There's a day for Matt Boswell, right over 50 pitches. A whole lot of them in the first inning.
Nice
strikes
pitch.
Out Ray, two gone.
Very nice pitch. Looked like a changeup. It was up in the zone, but just enough to keep Ray a little bit off his balance.
Tate Colwick is 0 for 1. He bounced back to the pitcher to lead off inning number 2. Bats here in the fourth with two out. Five straight retired by Boswell. Hits this one high and pretty deep to left. Not really going anywhere with the weather, and Wilson is under it for the third out. Three up, three down for Vanderbilt in the fourth. On to inning 5. Vanderbilt 2, South Alabama nothing in Nashville. Well, 2019 was a very good year for the Vanderbilt Commodores. 59 victories and a second national championship to finish off a great decade. Playing the home opener today, Vanderbilt hosting South Alabama, leading 2-0. Jack Leiter, how awesome has this guy been in his first start? 9 strikeouts, only 3 balls put in play. two by Caleb De La Torre, who's flat out to left twice, and bounce out by Santi Montiel. In the fourth, only one base runner. That was a walk to Ethan Wilson. Stranded at second. He pitches to Michael Sandel. He struck out to count for the second out of the second. And quickly in front, 0-2.
Mm-hmm. And those numbers, I mean, they might be a little bit deceptive. In nine strikeouts, only three balls put in play. I mean, he's not really nibbling on the corners. He's coming right after these guys. They just aren't able to put the ball in play.
Sandel sends that one to the screen as we check in with Kayla.
Guys, it's pretty amazing for a young kid like this making his debut today for Vanderbilt. He was obviously drafted in the 20th round by the New York Yankees, but he said, hey, don't even worry about drafting me to these major league teams, because he wanted to come here to Vanderbilt. And head coach Tim Corbin has high words, saying his maturity on and off the field quite noticeable. He's a low-maintenance player that comes to work. We have certainly seen that today on the mound, guys.
Yeah, definitely have, Kayla. And it's funny, we're saying some of the same things about Kamar Rocker this time last year. And I hope Leiter can have the same kind of impact as a freshman that Rocker did last year.
Yeah, Leiter's a highly touted kid coming into the Commodores bullpen.
Can't complain about those two guys, right, guys?
No, not
young,
at all.
Young and can get out there and get business taken care of.
Just, they both look like they've been there. That was close. 2-2. I think it's interesting that players have that kind of poise coming into the first starts of their college career at a place that's had so much success, and there's, you know, people watching you and scouts and all that stuff.
We actually talked a lot about that with Rocker last year. The game has changed so much with the younger kids as they're coming up through high school. They're going to a lot of these showcases. They're having cameras in their face. They're talking to a lot of scouts. There's so much access and exposure to these guys that once they get to the college level, it's not really that much different.
10th strikeout for Leiter. A good battle with Sandel. He wins it with a breaking pitch.
This is a good-looking slider on the outside corner. A good battle from Sandel, but good look at getting on top of that curveball.
One out for Reed Powers. He was called out on strikes in the second. Powers behind the plate today for Mark Calvey's team, which came in with a 2-1 record after taking two out of their opening three over the weekend. Back with a heater, it's 1-2. He is fantastic on the mound. Another strikeout. That's 11 as he sits down Powers for the second time.
I think he missed his spot a little bit there. Looks like he was trying to come inside, or at least Rodriguez was set up inside. That ball sneaked on the outside corner, but he's been around the plate all night.
So he gets Powers out on a fastball away. Delivers a first pitch strike to Dakota Daly. Called out to start the third. Drops in that breaking pitch, 0-2.
Leiter getting up there. Over 75 pitches. See the total 77. Gotta think, you know, early in the season, you don't want to let him go too far. It might be his last inning here. But the way these guys condition, you never know.
It's been a treat to watch. 2-2.
And we talked about how important these midweek games are, and to have a guy who comes in and gives you a stable performance like Mason Hickman did last year, and Jack Leiter done that tonight.
Well, he strikes out the side again, all swinging. He got Michael Sandel, Reed Powers, and Dakota Daly. Jack Leiter has been outstanding. Sandel on the breaking pitch. Powers away on the fastball. And Daly to end the fifth. Vanderbilt 2, South Alabama nothing. Halfway done. Vanderbilt leading South Alabama 2-0. First inning two-run single by Ty Duvall, accounting for the runs. And Jack Leiter, the freshman right-hander, has done the rest for Vanderbilt. It's a remarkable performance with a dozen strikeouts. Only one base runner allowed so far. And Boswell says, hey, I got a little love for me. I've sat down six in a row. Only allowed one hit since the first. That was a third inning single by Cooper Davis. We will see here in the fifth. 9-1-2 coming up. Tim Corbin's group will see Carter Young, Austin Martin, Cooper Davis. Young, a strikeout victim. That was back in the second in his first at bat. Bunts. That took a funny hop, and Boswell did a good job.
Yeah, I was going to say, even though that ball was popped up, I thought it was going to be a pretty good bunt for Young, but you'll notice it catches the turf, goes right into Boswell. Pretty good agility there from Boswell, the pitcher.
Mm-hmm.
As a left-hander, sometimes you try and get those pitchers to make some athletic movements, usually in your favor.
And get off the mound and make a play. Pop foul by Austin Martin. Reached on an error and scored in the first. Fly out to center. That was finishing off the second. The breaking pitch for strike two. Boswell ahead in the count. It's the Vanderbilt All-American Martin. Scored a program record 87 runs. Second in Commodore history with 105 hits last year and led the SEC with a 392 average. I was thinking watching him at the College World Series, just going to have too many at-bats to hit 400.
Mm-hmm.
He was over 400 pretty much the whole season, and you kept waiting for him to kind of level off a little bit, and just never happened. He was so good and consistent. This one hit out to left center for a base hit. Martin takes a big turn and will stop at first with a one-out single in the fifth.
Yeah, Kevin, I think the consistency that you talk about, as you see right here, the changeup that came right back inside. That consistency is really what a lot of those guys, they're sitting behind the home plate with the radar guns and with the stopwatches, are looking at for the draft. I mean, he is definitely up there as that number one pick, along with a couple other guys in that conversation. Just the offensive consistency and the amount of different places he can play on the field, how versatile he is. Should be fun to watch in the spring.
You talk about him playing in the field. We've seen him just be outstanding, whether it was in left field or third base. We've seen him other spots. Cooper Davis, a bunt single in the first and a base hit to center in the third. 2-for-2. Scored a run, stole a base. Vanderbilt wearing the same uniform combination they wore when they clinched in Omaha back last June. Like the new black jerseys with the gray pants they wore over the weekend. That was good stuff in the game Saturday. Martin was leaning a little or stumbled a little and got back to the base.
I think he was leaning a little bit. Probably trying to draw a throw from Boswell.
Oh, A little closer that time as Boswell tries to keep him close.
Yeah, Kevin, we'll see how, regarding the uniforms, how many times they bring out the black pinstripes. Mm-hmm. We got mixed reviews on those from some people. Some people loved them. Some people weren't too excited about them.
A lot of it becomes kind of a whatever works type thing as Martin goes on a 1-0 pitch. He's going to make it. The ball ends up in center field, but he'll stay at second. Second stolen base of the day for the Commodores, and he's in scoring position with one out.
It looked like Martin got a pretty good jump, although I think a good throw from Powers might have gotten him. Would have been close.
It was well to the third base side and not far enough away for Martin to advance to third. Two balls and no strikes to Davis. Three and 0 with C.J. Rodriguez on deck. Hoping he'll be batting with two aboard. Boswell throws a strike. Three balls and one strike. In those two first inning runs, Boswell, he had sat down seven straight before that single by Martin. Battling back against Davis.
Mike Davis got a little swing happy with a 3-1 change up in the outside corner. With that runner at second base, just trying to get something through the infield and knock him in.
Payoff misses. First and second with one out. That is the first walk issued today by Matt Boswell. Mound visit from the South Alabama dugout.
Yeah, we'll say with, even though it has been raining the entire game and in the wet conditions, both Boswell and Leiter have been around the plate pretty clean.
You always wonder who has the advantage in conditions like this. And I used to think it would be the pitchers, but I think keeping a grip on the baseball seems like a real challenge.
Mm-hmm. Also, as a pitcher, when you are out there in the rain, just being able to get your infield and your outfield into the dugout as quickly as possible is so important. Having been in the infield and some long innings with the rain pouring on you, it's not very fun. And then when all of a sudden a ball's hit at you, you're not really ready for it.
C.J. Rodriguez was certainly ready to start the season. He had six hits on opening weekend, 0 for 2 today. Couple doubles and drove in three runs. Vanderbilt went out to Scottsdale and started things off. A fifth inning threat holding a 2-0 lead. Runners go. Bouncer over to third. Rodriguez is out as Martin and Davis advance to second and third. Two out for Ty Duvall.
Tim Corbin trying to get something moving, gets the runners in motion. Stokes does a good job not getting distracted by the runners. And a nice pick over there by De La Torre. Just trying to hope that ball is going to get through the infield, but Commodores have still runners in scoring position, but have two outs. Going to need something to come through here for Ty Duvall.
Duvall delivered back in the first. The same combination of runners on the bases. That was with one out. He brought in two, counting for the only runs of this game so far. Base hit here would double Vanderbilt's leads. We play in the fifth. Boswell trying to keep it where it is. Lebanon, Ohio native, Ty Duvall. So good little activity in both bullpens. Tyler Perez getting ready for South Alabama. Hoping they can at least get one more out for Matt Boswell. Ball and a strike. In front against Duvall.
A really good pitch against Duvall. That back foot slider. Big pitch here for Boswell. See if he tries to go soft away, get Duvall to roll over something to his second baseman.
Martin in third, Davis at second. Boswell trying to make a pitch and will step off.
I thought that had potential to be a balk there. It looked like he started to move a little bit, his front foot. I think he got off the mound in time. Always on balk watch up here.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Takes a long time before coming set, and Duvall, the veteran, steps away. Martin dancing around on that third baseline. Boswell misses away. It's 2-2.
It did go soft away. Just tried to have a backdoor slider on the outside corner. Doesn't come back in enough.
Duvall can reach. Isaiah Thomas will bat. Again, outside. It's full.
I think they're going to continue to stay away from Duvall. You do have the base open with a younger hitter next. Don't want to make a mistake in the middle part of the plate.
And there is ball four. So Duvall works a walk after falling behind in the count, and they will be loaded for Isaiah Thomas.
Now, I thought that was a pretty solid pitch, too. Just inside the zone enough to try and get Duvall to make a swing at it, but just outside enough. Really good changeup there. Nothing hurt there for Boswell.
Duvall moves down to first. Duvall at first, Davis second, Martin at third for Isaiah Thomas. A base hit in the first, a line out in the third. 1-for-2. Trying to do some two-out damage. Swinging first pitch.
And this is a kid I'm really excited to see get some more at-bats. And we saw him very sparingly last year. But a highly touted recruit coming in last year. Obviously didn't get a lot of shots because of the team they had.
You kind of know in this program, you hang around, you're going to get an opportunity at some point, especially as talented as these guys are. Had a good opening weekend. Sends this one to shortstop. Throw across by Montiel. Ends the inning. Vanderbilt leaves him loaded. A base hit, three stranded. Still 2-0 Vanderbilt after five. Well, the day is finished, and what a debut for Jack Leiter, the Vanderbilt freshman. He sat him down one after another. Dozen strikeouts in the day. Andrew, how good was he?
Very impressive. Really just came after those hitters. Attacked him with the fastball. Saw a couple of different breaking pitches, a good slider on the outside corner to the right-handers, and mixed in a kind of a more over-the-top breaking pitch, and a few change-ups, but good arsenal there for Jack Leiter. Excited to see how he fits into the rotation towards the end of the year.
Gives way to Thomas Schultz, another freshman right-hander. He's from Mount Carmel, Pennsylvania. Tim Corbin jokes about players wearing their height on their uniform numbers, and Thomas does that at 6'6 and 215. Guy who won the Omaha Challenge for pitchers last fall. Tim says a very good athlete, as evidenced by his high school achievements in baseball and basketball. Well, there you go. And some debut for number 22. Commodore fans look forward to a whole bunch more of that.
Mm-hmm.
12 strikeouts and 16 batters faced. Only the one base runner. That was the fourth inning walk to Ethan Wilson. 8-9-1 coming up against Schultz here in the South Alabama sixth.
Yeah, it is so early. Who the Commodores threw out there last year, or sorry, last weekend with Rocker and Hickman and Eater. And if Leiter keeps putting up numbers like that, you got to think, I mean, do you move one guy around? Under all speculation, very early, sure. But Commodores do have a lot of arms.
Yeah, I think there were some who wondered if he might be in the weekend rotation to start the year. And there's a breaking pitch missing away, 2-1. Alden Davis struck out in the third and is only at bat so far.
As we mentioned, I mean, that's what Hickman did last year. He was the midweek guy. He had such consistency that they moved him into that weekend role. Had some big, big games towards the end of the year. Obviously, that last one was pretty good.
The biggest one, the biggest of them all. 2-2 pitch. Strike three. Schultz picks up where Leiter left off, and Davis is called out on strikes to start the sixth.
It's just a good fastball in the inside corner. With Schultz, with his height, it's a lot of angle on that thing.
It looked like it had a little run there. First big strike to Carter Quinn, the right fielder. Called out in the third. Yeah, we're talking about Mason Hickman, and man, he got ready to pitch that last game against Michigan. You couldn't tell if it was a midweek start or if right. It was the biggest game of his life. I mean, just kind of that even keel.
Yeah, I think that's what Tim Corbin was saying too. I mean, when he gave him the ball, I mean, it was just like it was a midweek game or it was the last game of the World Series. You couldn't tell. I think that's the way last year's team took every game, was just one game at a time. It didn't matter who they were playing. And that's why they had such success.
2-2 pitch, two strikeouts for Schultz. It's Davis looking, Quinn swinging. 14 for Vanderbilt's pitchers today.
The ball had some good run on it. Started off in the middle part of the plate, starts to run off. Schultz really coming after these hitters.
Top of the order, and Hunter Stokes 0 for 2 with 2 Ks.
You mentioned Schultz also put a little bit of basketball. Tim Corbin really likes to recruit those two-sport guys, the guys that compete in other sports, because baseball, sometimes with the showcases, I mean, you can get by on a good fastball, get by on, you know, taking some ground balls or taking good batting practice, but when you play basketball, you play football, you're having to compete and really play the game, and so he just really likes guys that get in there and get it done.
Well, you hope that Schultz is as good as the last 66 for Vanderbilt, Drake Fellows, who became a Friday night starter, 2-2, runs full. Payoff pitch. End of inning. Seen this movie before. Three hitters, three strikeouts for Thomas Schultz out of the Vanderbilt bullpen. 15 Ks today for Vanderbilt pitching. South Alabama still without a hit. Bottom of the sixth coming up. Two nothing Vanderbilt leading South Alabama. Home opener for the Commodores today. A two-run single by Ty Duvall in the first. Matt Boswell has kept him off the scoreboard since then, including some good work in the fifth when he got out of a bases-loaded situation. He is back for inning six. Got a save over the weekend in their opening series, and really pitching well here in Nashville, overshadowed by what Vanderbilt's pitchers have done, but he's been excellent in his own right as he pitches to Spencer Jones to start the inning. Jones, Ray, and Colwick coming up for Vandy. Tall Vanderbilt first baseman, your number one in a Vandy uniform. Pops this one up. Out to short left. Wilson gets under it for the first out. Jones out. It brings up Harrison Ray. Popped out to second and struck out. That was back in the fourth, 0 for 2. Much farther Boswell will go in this game. They had a reliever up in the bullpen last inning when had runners on base. Andrew, you said it last inning. You get guys in there, give you five or six good innings. Mm-hmm. This time of year, you can take that and move on.
Yeah, definitely. A team like South Alabama comes in. Get a really good performance by your pitcher.
Well, down to third, and Stokes couldn't get it. It was a hard hit ball, and like he's going to make a play. It got through, and Ray reaches one out.
He looked just under the glove of Stokes. Looks like he tried to come up and get it on the short hop, but just gets underneath there.
Scored an error. That's the second one of the day for South Alabama.
I was saying, if you're South Alabama and you have a guy who goes out there and gives you a great performance, it's a risky to bring somebody else in to a situation like this when they're down by two. I mean, you have somebody who has a good rhythm and keeps you at that two-run deficit to hopefully get your guys in there and get a couple more runs. Just depends on how much you trust your bullpen.
Yep. Ray running on the first pitch. Got a good jump. No chance to get him at second. Get back over and make sure he stays on the base. After he reaches on the air, he steals his way into scoring position.
It looked like Ray was determined to go right from that first pitch. You see that back right foot slips just off. Still a little bit slick. Not nearly as bad as what it was before.
I was thinking the same thing. You know, and watching some of these base runners and slides, it doesn't look nearly as slippery as the old turf was. Even when that older turf was new. They have changed the scoring decision. And that was a base hit for Ray. That originally put an error on the scoreboard. He stands at second. Tate Colwick in the box with one out and Manning scoring position, 0 for 2 day. Ray is the first base runner for the bottom of the Vanderbilt batting order. Colwick couldn't hold up. 2-2. We kind of talked some about last year's team, and you think about the bottom of the batting order last year. It just seemed like there were no easy outs, and everybody was dangerous and could get a lot of production out of those bottom three slots.
It was interesting, though. It took them a while to get there. I mean, Tim Corbin rolled out so many different lineups at the beginning of the year to finally find that one that fit towards the end.
Ray takes off for third. Again, he gets a good jump, and that's his second stolen base of the inning.
I see a jump lead there by Ray. Might have hurt his left or right hamstring a little bit.
Some kind of reach for it there after the steal was completed. Payoff pitch. Pollock pops it up. Get there. Well, the first baseman, De La Torre, says that'll be my play for the second out.
It's a big out there by Boswell. To get him to pop out, I mean, that's what you're trying to do, get him an easy pop out or a strikeout. Now you got two outs. Get your team back in there, just a two-run deficit.
You get that runner to third, especially with no outs, but also with one out. You got a really good chance of bringing him home, and now job gets more difficult. Young a chance here with two out, an 0-for-2 day. Well, an early play for Kayla.
A little bit out of her reach.
Yeah,
we'll give her that.
That was out of the area.
I don't think Max would have even had that one.
No, I don't think so either.
I feel like Kayla has a little bit more range than Max.
Yeah, I would say so. Ball and one strike to Carter Young.
Hey, guys, when I covered minor league baseball in Tucson, Arizona, I used to shoot my own stuff. And I said quick reflexes because I literally had a ball come inches from my face with the camera still holding up. Didn't hit me, though.
But
didn't
you held the shot, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I got to hold those shots.
That's most important.
Got to get those.
Hang with it. Got to be alert down there, man. Those dugouts are really close to the field in this ballpark.
Mm-hmm.
1-2 pitch. Do it again as Young sends it out of play.
Yeah, they've moved the TV cameras up into the stands, but they used to be kind of in the pits where the guys are taking pictures down by where Kayla is. I remember seeing some rocketed foul balls down there and some cameramen get hit.
Pulled to the first base side, a play for Daly, and ends the inning. Matt Boswell works out of some trouble. Harrison Ray reached on a hit with one out, stole second, stole third, but ends up at third and continues to be a 2-0 lead for Vanderbilt as we move on to the seventh. Some Jag fans in the house looking for a base hit. Vanderbilt leading 2-0 as we go to the seventh. Good spots in the batting order coming up. 2, 3, and 4 for USA up for Mobile. Team ranked in the top 25 to start the year and the preseason favorite in the Sun Belt Conference. Vanderbilt pitching has shut him down. 15 strikeouts, 3 by Thomas Schultz, who entered the game in the sixth after the outstanding 5 innings turned in by Jack Leiter and proceeded to strike out the side. And jumps in front 0-2 against Santi Montiel. Called out on strikes in the first and a bounce out to second in the fourth. And a 3-pitch strikeout with the breaking ball to start the seventh.
And Schultz has not wasted any time. Goes fastball, curveball, curveball. Up in the zone, drops in the top. Move on to the next one.
Visit Mark Calvi. Talking it over with our plate umpire, Scott Klein. The discussion about balls and strikes,
yeah,
maybe,
so.
And a pitch up.
I think Montiel was not happy about that. Might have said something to home plate umpire, Scott Klein. Scott Klein said, I don't like it.
Well, Ethan Wilson has been the only base runner so far for USA. That was on a fourth inning walk. He stole a base. That happened with two out and was left in scoring position. Scorecard that has been littered with strikeouts other than that. Big bouncer Martin playing in the shortstop spot and safe at first for the first hit of the day for South Alabama. Close play. Wilson beats it.
Yeah, Martin was played at shortstop on the big shift. I was thinking he was taking a little bit too much time. And indeed he was. And take a look at the play here. Yeah, he was safe. Martin kind of lollygagging, getting the ball out of his glove. A little bit different when you're kind of fielding that ball at shortstop as opposed to third base. The ball gets to you pretty quickly.
Two shot foul down the third baseline. Yeah, maybe that extra little pump there before he made the throw. Caleb Dellatore has had two flyouts to left in the second and fourth, as you see there, 0 for 2. South Alabama just hoping for that big swing that and get him back even or get him back within a run here. Ethan Wilson, the preseason All-American, down at first. Bounces off. The pitch is downstairs, 1-1. Delator, as we mentioned earlier, another preseason All-Sun Belt selection. Wave and a miss, 1-2.
A good changeup there by Schultz. Just trying to get Delator to roll over something, get a ground ball, and get out of this inning.
Martin, even with a bag at third, double play depth elsewhere. He's going to try out the left fielder, Davis, again. Three at bats, three flyouts, two out.
The rain is tapered off. The ball is really not traveling very far in the outfield. A lot of these balls that have been hit tonight I thought had a little bit more juice on it, but everything just dying.
Yeah, a couple times off the bat, balls to the outfield look like it might travel a little farther, or maybe in different weather they would, but you're right, just not going anywhere. Here's Michael Sandel. Like a lot of hitters in the USA lineup, 0 for 2, two strikeouts. Trying to extend a four-game hit streak that goes back to last season. Played in 50 games, 46 starts. Schultz with a breaking pitch. Short lead at first, a rocket out of play, 0-2. Sandel, in addition to being good at the plate, was excellent in the outfield. Only one error and 127 chances in center last year.
Schultz came inside on Sandel. Sandel was pretty far behind it. You saw the ricochet foul and then tried to come back with a breaking pitch. I think he might try and come back with something hard again. Nope.
Got him swinging.
Away.
Yep. That ends the inning. Good job by Schultz to battle back after allowing the first hit of the night for South Alabama. An infield hit by Ethan Wilson. He is stranded at first. Time for the stretch in Nashville. Commodores stacking up the strikeouts, leading 2-0. Well, Miami native Tyler Perez becomes the second pitcher of the day for South Alabama. Vanderbilt leading 2-0 as we go to the bottom half of the seventh inning. After six excellent innings from Matt Boswell, he gave up the two-run single to tie Duvall in the first, but then shut out the Commodores after that. Worked around some base runners, and the senior Perez will try to hold him right there through a scoreless inning in game three of their weekend series against Campbell. 18 games, four starts as a junior. His 3.67 ERA last season was second among relief pitchers on this team. Pitch to the top third of the Vanderbilt batting order. Austin Martin, Cooper Davis, C.J. Rodriguez coming up.
And Perez coming with a little bigger angle than Boswell. Now that sidearm angle, about 88 to 84. Not going to blow anything by you, but a lot of run on the ball. You kind of start your swing, and then by the time you make a connection with the ball, it's already moved a couple inches. Definitely going to make sure it's in the zone.
One for three for Austin Martin. Reached on an error and scored in the first. Base hit, stole a base, was stranded at third in the fifth. Three balls, no strikes. It across to make it 3-1. Commodore is trying to get back even after a 1-2 start out in Arizona over the weekend. Martin takes strike two. That's a piece of it on the payoff pitch. We'll do it again. Top two spots in the Vanderbilt batting order have been on a combined five times today. We'll see Cooper Davis in a moment. Martin hanging in there.
And Perez looks like he's found the zone. A good little battle between these two guys. I mean, only a two-run deficit. Mm-hmm. But it really feels like a lot more just because there hadn't been much offense from South Alabama.
Liner toward the gap in left center. Martin has his second hit. Both in that same spot. Leadoff man aboard in the seventh.
That being said, the Commodores definitely would love some insurance runs. That's how they're going to do it. Get this guy on. Good look at the side swing there. Loves to wear out that left center field gap.
Cooper Davis, two hits and a walk. Stolen base. Scored Vanderbilt's second run. Came home on the same hit that brought in Martin, that single by Duvall. He's done that before today. That's a risky play by Perez, but he gets to the base. If you're going to try to do that, mm-hmm. Andrew, I guess you got to be all in instead of making the toss.
Yeah, it's a heck of a play by Perez. I don't think he saw that Daly was there. So he said, I got to take it myself. Got to beat the runner to the bag. And Cooper Davis bowling down the line. Pretty impressive there from a pitcher.
So Davis trying to get on with a bunt single for the second time is out, but Martin moves into scoring position with one gone for C.J. Rodriguez. Breaking pitch, strike one, 0 for 3 day for the Vanderbilt freshman catcher. First-year players getting some work. We start this 2020 season. Rodriguez, one of those four freshmen that played all three games over the weekend. 15 of them on the roster, 8 played in the opening three games in Arizona. As a group, they went 12 for 41, scored 10 of the 17 runs, and knocked in 10 runs. Outside corner, 1-2. Dropped down.
Right on the outside corner.
Powers helped him out a bit, looked like. Outside, 2-2. Taida Vols had the big hit in this game, waiting on deck after Rodriguez is done. Good lead at second by Austin Martin. Another full count.
Rodriguez has gotten a lot of playing time since Duvall's been hurt and sick. Really shown what he can do at the plate, but these early games are so important for a lot of these freshmen to just continue to produce so that when some of those older guys get back in, they're able to kind of show Coach Corbin, hey, I deserve to stay in that lineup. And Rodriguez really has done that.
On base for the first time today with a walk, and that brings up Duvall with runners at first and second, one out. Two RBI single, line out to right, and a walk for Duvall in the DH spot. Strike and a breaking pitch. Opening weekend saw Vanderbilt go 9 for 53 with runners on base. Today they have gone 3 for 13. One for 10 with runners in scoring position. Duvall has that hit. Bounces this one to second. They only get one and are probably fortunate to get that many. Daly delivers to Montiel. And now the runner coming home. I think South Alabama thought time was called as Martin came home to score. We'll see if they send him back. And Montiel is injured on the play out at second base.
Yeah, regardless, it was a heck of a play by Montiel. Yeah, the ground ball to Daly. The tag of Rodriguez. He's on the ground. Umpire does not call time. You see Martin heads up all the way, scores from second base. Now they're arguing that he called time for the injured player, Montiel. But no time looked like it was ever called.
Take one more look and let's see.
He calls him out.
And now Montiel starting to figure out that he's hurt. Flips the ball back to the pitcher, and Perez at that moment notices Martin coming home from third.
Yes, second base umpire Ranley Hundley did not call time. I don't know if they were saying somebody else may have. But Randy Hundley right there did not. Just made the out call.
And a heads up play by Martin because, you know, the worst that can happen is they send you
right
back to third base.
Exactly.
Perez will come out of the game after Vanderbilt makes it 3-0. The run counts for Martin. Isaiah Thomas will be in the box. We'll tell you about the new hitter when we come back. Seventh inning in Nashville. William Georgia native Collier Baggett becomes the third pitcher for South Alabama in the second of this inning. He'll enter the game with two outs and a runner at first and a run in for Vanderbilt. An important third run crossing. Baggett threw on Sunday, actually threw in the second game on Saturday, two and a third innings. Gave up three hits and an earned run. A couple years at Tallahassee Community College. And he's just a great athlete in high school. He played 4 years of football, basketball, baseball, and track at Westwood Schools in Georgia. The state champion in the triple jump and in the long jump.
Don't see many track baseball athletes.
No, not very many, do you?
Overlap.
Uh-huh.
I feel like you'd have to pitch and then put his spikes on.
Yeah, throw a couple innings and head over and do the triple jump. .64 and .205 in relief of Tyler Perez. Like South Alabama might have a double play that would have finished off the inning. But a play at second base and a shaken up shortstop, Montiel. Martin came across to score Vanderbilt's third run. Pulled foul past Tim Corbin. No balls and two strikes to Isaiah Thomas. 1-for-3, base hit in the first. Line out to center and a bounce out to short. The ball reached on the fielder's choice. This is outside third and foul. Also said on Collier Baggett's bio that he was an Atlanta Falcons fan and a Tom Brady fan, which I don't know how that works, you know, when you think of the whole 28-3 situation. Oh, and two. Missed off the plate. Ball and two strikes. Thomas continues to battle. Well, they call a balk and Duvall goes to second. There's your balk.
Yep. I was going to say there, the pitch before that, even the one he balked on, I thought he's going a little bit fast. He definitely didn't come set. See here. Actually, I don't know. I think before he kind of brought his hands down a little bit further.
Maybe jerked a little bit.
I don't know. I feel like Scott Klein might have been a little bit ball cappy on that one.
It's early in the season to be ball cappy.
I thought there was enough of a pause there.
Yeah, it looked like. I was with you. I thought it looked like he stopped. And sometimes even if you do something a little unusual, if you do it every time, then
right,
they won't call it.
Right.
Unless you're Vanderbilt's Ethan Smith and you end up changing your delivery. Two balls, two strikes. Fly ball to deep right, but foul. The longest one's been hit today. Well, not traveling in this weather.
That ball actually went a really long way for his kind of a flick of a swing that was by Thomas, trying to fight it off. Good at bat here by Isaiah Thomas, a sophomore.
Another 2-2 pitch. To short. Inning over as Montiel makes the play. A run on one hit and one left. Vanderbilt adds a big run, leading 3-0 after seven. Better bring the ponchos if you're hanging out here today. Vanderbilt 3, South Alabama nothing. Some hardy folks hanging in here. Kevin Ingram, Andrew Harris, Kayla Anderson, Doug Stanton, our whole crew. You're supposed to have a nice day for the opener, aren't you? You know, come out here and kind of ease into things.
The crowd's definitely dwindled.
It's actually probably better now than it has been throughout a lot of the game. This guy's been good, Thomas Schultz. In relief of Jack Leiter, who threw 5 hitless innings with a dozen strikeouts, and Schultz has added 5 more Ks to that total, 17 of them today for Vanderbilt pitching. Faces Reed Powers, Dakota Daly, Alden Davis. First, it's the South Alabama catcher 0-for-2. Out to short for Young. One gone. There's only the second ground ball out today recorded by the Commodores. The other one was to Harrison Ray back in the fourth inning. Dakota Daly also 0-for-2. Only base hit, an infield single by Ethan Wilson, last inning. Big breaking pitch for strike one.
Yeah, both Leiter and Schultz have just been filling up the strike zone. They haven't been trying to nibble off the corner or anything, just attacking these hitters. Hitters just haven't really put it in play. You look at the scoreboard and only one hit. A lot of times that shows guys are trying to strike people out, but been very efficient with their pitches so far.
Buried that one, 1-2. Senior Daly. A couple years of JUCO ball at Northwest Community College in Mississippi. Also played some college basketball a few years ago.
I think something a lot of young pitchers try and do is they come in and try and strike everybody out. And I think the Vanderbilt staff and a lot of the older pitchers teach a lot of the younger guys, hey, that's not what you have to do. Just pitch it in there, pitch strikes, and let that defense work behind you. And good things will happen.
Hey, you come in with this kind of arm and you're used to playing high school ball where just mowed everybody down and let them work for you. Went back to that breaking ball and strikes out Daly for the second out.
Such a big breaking ball coming from the right side all the way across the plate. You get a big, long look at it. Just not able to get a piece of it.
The fastball strike to a pinch hitter for South Alabama. Preston Welchel, he is a freshman out of Cartersville, Georgia. Batting for Alden Davis with two outs in the eighth. Now golfs this one out towards short. Play by Young, close at first. And Jones holds the base to end the inning. Three up, three down in the Jaguars' eighth. Nice little play on both ends. Using that height, Jones holds the bag, 3-0 Vandy. Eighth inning coming up for Vanderbilt. Spencer Jones, Harrison Ray take Colwick. Commodores in front, 3-0. Added a big run on a hustling play by Austin Martin last inning. Jones leads it off. First pitch sends it out to left for Wilson. Few steps toward the line, one gone.
Interesting swing there by Jones. Kind of inside out that ball, especially on a first pitch. Might have just flipped off his bat a little bit weird.
Harry Ray is 1-for-3. Infield single, stole two bases in the sixth and ended up at third after a pop out and a strikeout. Started up an 11-game homestand for Vanderbilt. Going to Arizona, they'll head back west a little bit later in the pre-conference. 0-2. Collier back, it came in and got the last out of the seventh for South Alabama. Harrison Ray on three strikes is the second out of the eighth.
Ray didn't like the high strike before that, so tries to swing at that curveball up in the zone, not able to come up with it. Collier's down two.
And the Vanderbilt center fielder Tate Colwick steps in 0-for-3. Looking for his first hit of the day. Only into the opening weekend was a double. Count 3-0. Chance to reach for the first time today. Get Carter Young to the plate. Four-pitch walk after the three-pitch strikeout.
McCulloch's another one of those kids like Thomas who didn't get a lot of opportunity last year. We can play a lot of different positions, playing in the outfield today, but we saw him a little bit in the infield last year. I think we see that from a lot of the Tim Corbin's recruits, is guys that, you know, have experience in one position, but he says, well, you know, somebody's already at that position, so you got to go try something else.
Eighth inning pitching change for South Alabama. We'll take a timeout as well. Two outs and one on. Vanderbilt leading 3-0 over South Alabama in the home opener. More to come from Nashville in a moment. Well, senior Andy Arguelles will try to get the final out of the eighth for South Alabama. Andy, 5'11", 180, a senior. He threw two-thirds of an inning over the weekend. He got the win after 35 appearances in his first three seasons. Vanderbilt. So Collier back and get the first two outs of this inning. Then Tate Colwick reached on a four-pitch walk. And USA goes back to the bullpen for the fourth pitcher of the day. Matt Boswell was really good for six innings. Corbin's team looking to get back even. South Alabama coming in at 2-1. Young 0 for 3. Goya is the first left-hander to throw for either team today. Still more activity going on. Zach Harlan getting loose. Same two teams tomorrow, same time, 4:30. You're on SEC Network Plus. There's a liner to center. That is the final out of the eighth as the sure-handed Sandal makes the catch. Runner stranded onto the ninth. Vanderbilt 3, South Alabama nothing. Vanderbilt 3 outs away from getting back to 500 in the home opener today, leading South Alabama 3-0. The pitching for Vanderbilt has been amazing. 18 strikeouts, only a couple base runners. And really, only one player has been on base, and that is Ethan Wilson. A walk in the fourth and an infield single in the seventh. That's been it. Jack Leiter for five. Thomas Schultz since then has been really impressive. This is Vanderbilt debut. 9-1-2 for USA. Carter Quinn starts things off. 0 for 2 with two strikeouts. Say that about a whole bunch of people in this batting order. See Young shading him up the middle. Hard throwing Schultz trying to finish it off, get a save.
The difference of that 91 mile an hour fastball and then that 83 mile an hour changeup up there, it looks exactly the same. Very tough to tell the difference. It's an easy 91-92 with that big size.
Those big dudes always make it look easy. Throwing hard. 2-2 pitch. Served out to left. That'll be the second hit of the day and a good start to the ninth inning for South Alabama.
I saw a little piece of hitting there by Quinn. Knew that Schultz was going to be coming after him, most likely with that fastball. Yeah, threw his hands out there, didn't even finish the swing. He's got a base runner, and that's all they need. Get Schultz out of that windup, get him in the stretch, trying to get that running game going.
So the second hit for South Alabama, and the first one has left the infield. Let's get back to the top, and they have some experienced guys who can swing the bat. Hunter Stokes has had a rough go of it, 0 for 3 with 3 Ks. Two against Leiter, one against Schultz. A walk-off home run back on Friday to start the season. Rolls over to the right side. A play made by Jones gets to the base. Quinn advances, one out.
Good job there by Jones. Just not trying to do too much. Didn't try and turn it. Realized that Quinn too far. He gets the out.
Santi Montiel, the USA shortstop, will bat. He walked and stole a base in the fourth. He batted ahead of Ethan Wilson, who did all that. He bounced out right in the middle of two strikeouts, both called. There is a strike, 0-2. Man in scoring position, Montiel in the box. Just looking for outs at this point to finish it off. Missed away, 1-2.
Hit his spot exactly right there. A couple inches off the plate, just trying to get Montiel to nibble. I think he could probably come back with something very similar, but just right on the corner.
Montiel with two RBIs in the opening weekend. Strikes out here for the second out of the ninth. Make it 19 Ks for Vanderbilt pitching today.
It goes with the elevated fastball. As we mentioned multiple times, with his size and Schultz, that ball just continues to run when he goes a little bit more arm side. Rode up in the zone, down to his final out. See if he can close this thing out.
We got Ethan Wilson where you want him, and that is not with a chance to tie the game with one swing. He has been on base twice. He was the first base runner in the fourth with a walk and then the first hit of the day, and that was in the seventh. Big rip, 0-1. Strike two, quickly in front of Wilson. Schultz, pitch away from finishing it off.
Schultz started him off with a changeup away, went with a fastball. I think we'll see pitch number three, the curveball today.
0-2 pitch coming up to Wilson. Fly ball, short left, Davis. And Vanderbilt wins 3-0 over South Alabama. Power stuff from a pair of freshman right-handers. Jack Leiter for the first five hitless and Thomas Schultz for the last four. Those guys were excellent. 19 strikeouts and only two hits today.
Yeah, pretty unbelievable. Offensively, not really much to show for either team, but all the Commodores had to do was get a couple runs. As you mentioned, the pitching performance by Leiter and Schultz was lights out. Really exciting for this Commodore bullpen and see what happens the rest of the year.
We'll do it again tomorrow. Vanderbilt, 3 runs, 7 hits, no errors, 9 left. South Alabama, no runs, 2 hits, 1 error, and 3 left on. Do it again tomorrow, 4:30 Central, 5:30 Eastern. For Andrew Harris, Kayla Anderson, producer Doug Stanton, I'm Kevin Ingram saying so long from Nashville, a presentation of the SEC ESPN Network.